Hello everyone. Now, today let's talk about asynchronous sequential logic. So in the name itself, you can see that there is asynchronous. That means it is the two signals are not in sync with each other. And this sync will only come when there is a clock pulse. So here you can see that asynchronous sequential circuits do not use clock signals as synchronous circuits do. Synchronous circuits always work on clock, that is, each and every transition is based on clock, but that is not the case of asynchronous. Then how does this asynchronous proceed? That means how does the sequential logic take place? So it is taking place instead, the circuit is driven by the pulses of inputs, which means the state of the circuit changes when the inputs change. Now instead of the clock pulse change, these circuits will have their output change when input changes. I mean, when the input pulse changes, the output changes and the asynchronous sequential logic proceeds. And the change of internal state occurs when there is a change in the input variable. First the internal state changes and then the output. And now there should be some memory, because the present state and the next state only come into picture when there is some kind of memory. In the synchronous sequential logic, the memory is basically, you know, a flip-flop which is driven by a clock pulse. But here, there are unclogged flip-flops. There may be flip-flops, but they are unclogged, or there are time delay elements. And they are similar to combinational circuits with feedback. That is how basically a three sequential circuit will be. But since it is an asynchronous one, it won't have a clock pulse, that is, it won't have flip-flops having clock. It may have unclogged flip-flops or a time delay elements. Now let's take a look comparison between both the sequential circuits. In the synchronous one, you see that you have a combinational logic. Have input and you have output, but we see that these outputs are fed back to digital storage, or these can be flip-flops that are driven by the clock, and these outputs are the next states. When they are passed through a flip-flop, they become the present states, and then they are again fed to the combinational logic. So these are very important to determine the state of the clock, state of the circuit at each clock pulse or at particular clock pulse. What is the next state? What is the present state? For example, if you determine the present state then at particular clock pulse, then you can predict what the next state may be. And with the help of that, you can, after studying the behavior of few next states and few present states, you can easily predict the behavior of the output. In the case of asynchronous, you see that there is no feedback element, no clock or no flip-flop that is driven by the clock. But instead, you can have a time delay element here or an unclocked pulse that will depend on the two types of asynchronous sequential circuit, which I'll be showing you now. So what are the advantages of not having any memory element here directly connecting next state to present state, or having a very small time delay? The advantage is that the operation of the asynchronous sequential logic circuit will be very high. The speed will be very high because you don't have to wait for the clock pulse every time you want to change a state, but instead you just need to change your input whenever you feel like that your states should change, and your output will also depend on these states. Now let us talk about the types of sequential logics. That is divided into two, that is asynchronous and synchronous. And in synchronous, they are again divided into pulse mode and fundamental mode. So in this video, we will be seeing the basics of fundamental mode. Now what are these? Let's talk about it. So in the fundamental mode circuits, so these circuits utilize unlocked memory and level variable input is composed of combinational block with one delay line memory element. Here you can see that there are n inputs and there are n outputs. Similarly, there are n next states which are denoted by capital Y, and there are n present states. Okay, sorry, this is RR, so that there should be a clarity. R present states, and you can see for each input there will be one output and there will be one next state that will be passing through one delay element, and we can get the present state as well. For each line there is a delay element. That is exactly what it means by one delay line memory element, and this delay is of delta t. Now, how this works, how do you determine the next state and the present state, how do you determine the output based on these states? We can all understand it when we do simple problems. So here you can see what is the legend, that is small x will be denoting the input state, capital Z will be denoting the output state, small y will be denoting the secondary or internal or present state, and the capital Y will be denoting excitation state or next state, and all these x1, x2, y1, y2 will be telling you the total state. Now for using this problems or doing this analysis, we need to make several assumptions. First assumption will be only one input variable is allowed to change. In this, you can see that there are n inputs. So we told that this asynchronous sequential logic circuit are triggered when any input is changed. That means we need to assume that only one input will be changed at one time. Then for reliable operation, input change should be spaced in time by at least delta t. That means there should be at least a duration of delta t when this input changes, so that you can differentiate between the next state and the present state. That there should be a minimum amount delta t. But it is only to understand what is the difference between the next state and state and present state. But you can see that a fundamental mode circuit is a stable state if its present state is same as excitation state, y is equal to y. Here you can see that whenever the input changes, this y will become this y, that is the next state will become the present state, okay, or present state may become a next state, but this transition is having a small delay element, that is delta t. But for a stable condition of the asynchronous logic circuit, this small y must be equal to the capital Y. That means this delay should be almost zero. Now we can consider that delay as zero because there is a very small delay element, that is delta t only. And when it is not equal, this, that means the present state and the next state are not equal, then they are known as unstable state. Now, why do we require the concept of stable states and unstable state? That is in the flow table. Now, what is a flow table? So, it is used to specify a behavior of fundamental mode circuit. Now, whenever you want to write the equations of a synchronous sequential circuit, you use a K-map, right? It is similar to this one. Similarly, when you want to write the equations or whenever you want to find which states are stable and which are not, you need to draw a flow table. Flow table is also similar. It is drawn between the inputs and the present state. And there are more flow tables which are drawn between the outputs and the next state. We will be able to understand when we do the problems. And now you can see that there are some states which are being encircled in the flow table. Now what are those? So in flow table, present states and next states are represented by letters or non-binary characters, and stable states are denoted by circle. You can see that the stable state, that means in this the state is A, that is the present state is A, and you can see the next state is also A, but here it's B and here it is A. So whenever this present state is equal to the next state, you will have to encircle it to show that these are only the stable states. Since A is not equal to B here, we are not encircling it. Similarly, when the present state is B, you can see for this one it is B, for this one B, for this one B. That means we need to encircle those states for which the present state is equal to the next state. So that's it. And we'll have to analyze analysis procedure that whenever you will be given a circuit, you will have to first determine the output equations for Z and Y. Then you have to develop the K map for Z and Y, that is the flow table. Then you have to combine those flow tables to form an excitation table. Then you have to locate the stable states. Then you have to construct the flow table by replacing each binary state in the excitation table. Okay, sorry, there is a difference between a K map. We need to draw a K map first, and then we have to draw the flow table. Finally, we have to represent the whole circuit in a flow table. So this is just how a circuit might look like. And you can see that there are inputs, there is some combinational logic here, which we were indicating with the box here. We were indicating by the box. Here you have some AND, some NOR, some NOT, some OR gates. Then you have a delay element. Okay. Now how do you analyze it? How do you draw the flow table? We'll be showing you in the next video. So please stay tuned.